Here we go! Here we go!
Hey everyone, I'm Kayla Grey and I am a host reporter at TSN. I also host and co-executive produce The Shift at TSN. The one thing I'll say while I was going through the darker times of my life was a constant was sport, and I was introduced to it at a very young age. It was all I played in order to stay busy and to have extracurricular activities, from track to cross country to volleyball to basketball to baseball, anything I just wanted to try. Now, my love of storytelling and sport came from my grandparents. I spent a lot of time with them growing up, and my grandmother would watch the Blue Jays games on television, but she'd watch it on mute. And in very old school fashion, my grandfather would have that exact same game going on the radio. And I just thought it was like the coolest thing to have picture and word align the way that it did, even though it was different voices and sets of storytelling. Just the way that it came together was what sparked my interest into sports media. It's funny how leadership came to be in my life through the Argos, because the person that actually encouraged me and essentially got me that internship was Michael Pimble Clemens, who is the general manager of the Argos right now. I was the game day in-game production wrangler. And what that means is, when it comes to the fan experience, I had a rundown and I had to make sure that the host of the game was in these different spots at an exact time. But what I learned through that experience was how to have agency and autonomy over my own role and make it my own. You know, I was there to learn and absorb as much as I possibly could. So I was asking questions. I was being very nosy and asking to get in trucks or talk to camera or talk to people that worked in the space, just to get a sense of what they did and what their why was. And through that, I was able to kind of navigate how I wanted to show up in that workspace, even though I was just an intern at the time. And I think that's what I carry on into my life and how I show up as a co-executive producer for my show now, is I love to give our team the space that they need to show up every single day as is and as themselves. I think the biggest hurdle of fear has probably been at the start of this entire story for me. So there was a lot of fear of showing up into a space that I assumed was incredibly professional and everyone came from the same background. I think I just did a lot of changing and conforming to make everybody else feel comfortable with me existing in the space. And it completely like ripped away all of my seasoning and sauce as to who I was as a person. And thankfully, I'll give that girl some grace, because it was a survival instinct and tactic to work in a space like this that is predominantly male and still in Canada, predominantly white. But what I'm understanding is that on the other side of that fear, what is the worst thing that can happen is not the question I should be asking. What is the best thing that can happen? Representation to me is so important. And we can look at it from a standpoint of seeing yourself and knowing how valuable that is. We know that if you can't see something, you don't believe that you can be it. When you have a diversity in thought and storytelling and angle and in ways in which you can go after something or bring something to the table, it's only beneficial to everybody. So that's why representation is so important. I love when I feel as though communities feel seen. It's so important for them to feel seen and that their stories matter, because they do, because they are a part of our makeup. And it's important that they have the same type of support and resources behind that type of storytelling. And, you know, when it comes to my platform and making sure that young women, and specifically young women of color, know that they can do what I'm doing, I think that that is the shift. We're also able to use that platform to highlight joy and contribution of marginalized folks. I don't think, personally speaking, I would have been able to meet the people that I've met, to hear the stories that I've heard, or to tell the stories that I've told without sport being that intro for me. But that is the power of sport. It has this beautiful way of bringing different types of people together for one common goal and connecting us, which is how we should be moving as a society. Favorite part about covering the Raptors championship parade? Yes, being stuck with Norman Powell for 8 hours, that was also fun. Chris Boucher was there as well. Danny Green, I think, was also on our bus. But most importantly, it was looking into the crowd and having this weird moment of seeing people that I went to West Scarborough Boys and Girls Club with. And I just remember going as a group to Raptors games and just being reminded of where that love came from, and not to make those big moments that happen in your career, like a Raptors championship parade, take you out of your why or take you out of the moment. I would tell my younger self to not talk yourself out of moving forward with life, or thinking that your path is too broken or traumatic or too wounded to find success again, or to find your life again, or to get back on the right path. I'm learning that grit can show up in two different ways. One, it could be in the hard work, it can be in the hustle, it can be in the preparation. That is my bag, that is who I am, that's how I am able to show up as good as I do on television. But I'm also learning grit in how I say no, and how I take time for me, and how I am very intentional about rest that I get, and time with my son or my family or by myself that I get. I think that life and society tells you that things are supposed to go one way and one way only, that you're supposed to make one choice about what you wanna do, who you wanna be, the things you wanna cover maybe within your space, and that's supposed to just be it for you. And I think when you have this freedom of saying, I've decided to change my mind today, or you know what, today I'd rather not, or I'm not that person anymore, there's power in that. Try to let go of the fear of what happens next. I think when you're in a position where you're holding on so tightly to a role or a job or an opportunity, and you're like, oh my God, what if I lose this? What if I lose this? Where am I gonna end up? What's next? When you're so focused in that fear, you're not present in the moment. And so when you get off and rid of that fear, you're able to expand in ways that you probably would have never imagined. My favorite chocolate bar is Cadbury milk. My favorite hobby is getting up, going outside for a long walk, and finding a beach. My favorite genre of music right now and forever and always will be 90s to 2000s hip hop and R&B specifically. A movie that I would watch time and time again is definitely The Lion King. My favorite thing about Toronto is Scarborough specifically. And why I love it so much is just the people and community here.